Children come into the world through existential crisis. Their state is one of lack of autonomy, lack of identity, and lack of existential isolation. Each child starts out its individual existence within a state of fusion, that is to say, its identity tangled up in the existence of its caretakers. While navigating its existence, a child, through experience and information gathering, develops a sense of self and personal identity. As the individual develops and transcends their fused family identity and shared worldview, it can be expected that anxiety and existential isolation will follow. The task of the existential therapist is to travel with their client down their path, providing them with opportunities to embrace their authentic self and realize the power they possess in their being by the choices they make. Lauren is a client from the metaphorical biography Lying. Lauren identifies as a 12-year-old female and reports a diagnosis of epilepsy with visual and scent auras. Lauren states that she is preoccupied with how she is perceived and is concerned that she is unknown to others and herself. Lauren expresses that she is very worried about the truth and that she is unsure of what is true and what is a lie sometimes. Lauren also reports that she lies and exaggerates often. Lauren shares that her mother has a very powerful presence and is an exaggerator and liar who never seems to be satisfied. She also reveals that her father is as tiny as a freckle when at home and spends a lot of time at work. Throughout her childhood, Lauren has been defined by her parents. Lauren is at the stage where she now realizes she is an individual and has begun to understand that throughout her childhood, she has been living fused to her mother's existence, protected and safe, however, unauthentic. This new visualization of being is causing Lauren to become overcome with anxiety. Where the once fused identity she shared with her family anchored her and provided her with a sense of security, the release of the fused identity has abruptly taken that safety away. Lauren does not yet believe that she holds the power through making choices to embrace her authentic self and shed her inauthentic self, a girl who is dirty, shaky, and dishonest. In Lauren's therapy, we engage in dialogue while creating art and playing. Lauren directs our play sessions, learning to make choices and explore her values. Lauren makes the rules and can change them in any way she likes at any time. When doing art in session, Lauren creates her own images based on a concept that I request to see. Outside of session, Lauren writes in a journal, recording events in her day and stories she creates, allowing her authentic self and her stories to become cohesive. Lauren attends group art therapy, where she works on creative projects aligned with her own interests to establish authentic meaning for herself, and shares dialogue with her peers where she can share her creations as self-expression and share her progress. Through her sessions, Lauren will become aware of the ways others make choices for her in everyday life, even though she is capable of making those choices for herself. Lauren will find that she allows her mother to make many of her choices for her, such as what she wears, eats, and music she listens to. Lauren will accept responsibility for the choices that she has made in allowing her mother to make these choices for her and allowing her to be viewed as her inauthentic self. Lauren will also accept responsibility for the emergence of her authentic self. Lauren will achieve this by actively making choices each day consistent with her wants, such as picking out her own clothes, deciding what she would like to eat for breakfast and lunch, perhaps preparing those things for herself, using her free time to pursue projects of her own interests and other appropriate life choices. Lauren learns that defining and being true to her own values and her authentic self, while sometimes scary, feels much better and honest. Lauren is coming to terms with being self-aware and isolated from her former fused identity. She is learning to use her anxiety as a guiding tool to define her personal truths in her everyday existence, and, even though she is existentially isolated, she can allow herself to be seen by others and develop relationships to help relieve the pain of that separation. Lauren chooses to tell you her story. Thank you.
Thank you.